Hi and welcome to my second video in the series about microorganisms and health. So what we're looking at today is the methods by which your body stops you getting ill. And so the first of which are physical barriers. And so these physical barriers include things like your skin. And you've probably noticed that if you feel your skin, it's got feels like a layer of oil. And within that that liquid that's produced, you have enzymes and you have chemicals which actually can break down bacteria. We also have tears, which inside these tears there are specific chemicals which again can break down microorganisms. And obviously if you were to ingest or swallow any microorganisms and they were to get into your stomach, which is quite likely, then the stomach acid, which has a very, very low pH, is able to digest and break down microorganisms quite effectively. But what would happen if they got through the physical barriers and then got inside your body, potentially through a cut or through a wound internally? And then once it gets into the bloodstream, what protects you on the inside? Well, you have a specific type of blood cell that actually deals with foreign infections, and these are called white blood cells, hence the drawing here. So in this diagram here, it's got your red blood cells and a typical white blood cell here. Now, the specific name for white blood cells is called leukocyte, and you might have heard the word leuko before and the word leukemia. So leukemia is a cancer of white blood cells. So anytime you hear the word leukocyte, that means white blood cell. And so the first type of white blood cell that the pathogen might encounter is called a phagocyte, spelled PH at the front. And the phagocytes work by ingesting and digesting microorganisms. So the diagram here gives an indication of how phagocytes work. So the blue blob that you see here is a phagocyte, and this is the nucleus of the phagocyte here. The purple section here might be a particular microorganism, probably a bacteria. Now essentially what happens is the bacteria is recognised as being foreign, and then it's engulfed into the phagocyte. And what will technically happen is the phagocyte will form a membrane around the foreign pathogen, and it will then release digestive enzymes that will break down the pathogen and then obviously eliminate the threat. Now, in order for the microorganism to be digested, we need to identify it as foreign, first of all. And basically, on the surface of a microorganism, or the surface of most cells, you have these things called antigens, and these are surface protein markers. And they're a bit like an identification method. So your cells, your red blood cells, have a specific type of antigen, and therefore your blood cells recognise, or your white blood cells recognise, your red blood cells as being yours. This is what can lead to problems when people have blood transfusions from different blood types, because different blood types have different antigens on them. Therefore your white blood cells see them as a problem, and they therefore try to digest them and break them down, obviously leading to serious complications. That's why you can't mix blood types. But it's also the same reason why your white blood cells will target certain pathogens, because they have antigens on their surface that are foreign. So in summary, you have physical barriers that stop microorganisms getting inside your body, and those are things like your skin, the tears and the stomach acid. If they do gain entry to your body and into your bloodstream, then they're first met by a type of white blood cell or a leukocyte called phagocytes. And phagocytes work by digesting and engulfing microorganisms. If you join me for the next video, then we'll be looking at the next stage in your immune response.